In this session of the Windows 11 tutorial, I'll demonstrate how to use File Explorer in Windows 11. File Explorer is a tool for navigating the files in your computer. To access File Explorer, we click here on File Explorer from the taskbar, and then on the left-hand side, we have here the Home option. This is a new option in Windows 11 that contains by default a quick access option such as the desktop, downloads, documents, pictures, and so on, favorites, folders, and items that you have marked as favorites, and then recent files. These would be files that you have been working on recently. Then on the left-hand side here, you'll have options such as OneDrive or items that you have marked as favorites or marked for quick access. Then further down, you have desktop, downloads, documents, pictures, and various key folders that you may want to access quickly. Further down here, we have the options for this PC and network. This PC, this is what lists the storage devices that you have in your computer. By default, every computer has a C drive, and then if you have a second hard drive, it will be listed something similar to this. But then if you have a CD-ROM drive in your computer, it would be D drive typically, or E drive. And then if you add a flash drive, this is where it will show up. So basically, to access any of those items, you'll need to click on this PC. And then further down, this is where you can navigate the files and folders in your computer. This is a recent update to Windows 11. Notice that there are now tabs that you can open. Instead of opening multiple windows to navigate through your files in your PC, you can now open a new tab very similar to a web browser for navigating the files in your PC. Now, at the very top here, if we go, let's say, to a location, let's say downloads in this computer, and if I want to create a new folder, I can click here on New. So notice we have these icons or menu items on right below the tab here. So if I want to create a new folder, I click on New and then choose Folder and then simply give it a name. From here, and I double clicked on it to access it. Now to create a new file, I could create it either using Word or opening a Word file and then creating it from the application. Or I could create the file directly from here as well. So if I click on New Word Document, I'm basically giving it a new name from here, and then it'll give me the option to double-click on it and then open it in Word. And it will save it to the location that I created this file. Once you select an item, notice that the other menu items in the top show up here after the item has been selected. So it's very similar to contextual tools in Office applications. To determine as to what these icons stand for, you need to hold the mouse on them and it'll display what the item is. Remember also that to modify any of these files, you can right-click on them and then you have other options as well related to that file. If I want this folder to be listed here under my favorite folders, all you have to do is you right-click on the folder and select Pin This to Quick Access. And notice point it'll add it here on the left-hand side. The advantage of the Quick Access is that anytime I'm working in File Explorer, instead of going to Downloads and then selecting my folder, I can click here on the left-hand side and it will take me directly to that folder. Now to copy a file, I can simply right-click and choose Copy, and then I can go to a different folder where I want to paste it and right-click in that location and then paste it. Obviously, this is a simple concept, but it's to demonstrate the usual functionality in Windows Explorer. Now to rename this file, I can simply right-click on it and choose Rename, or click over here in the file name and then choose the Rename icon. Notice there is also the sorting option here that I can sort them by name or by date. And then there is the View option, whether I want large icons or whether I like a listing of files or also the details for those files. There is also the compact view, the changing of the various views. So if you want to see more files in a compact way, you'd select this option. And you can also select from here whether you want to show the preview pane on the right-hand side. So if I click on this file, it will give me a preview of what that document contains. You can even have checkboxes under view here and then show. This is where you can also select to show hidden items or hidden files in Windows. Further to the right, we have these three dots. This is where you can see additional options, whether you want to select them all, or the properties for this folder, or options for File Explorer. So if we click here on Options, this is where we can configure in the system when you open File Explorer, if you wanted to see the Home tab, or if you want to go to this PC automatically here in the bottom. This is also where you can define whether you want to open each folder in the same window or in its own window, and whether a single click or double click on items to open them. Here is how you can clear the history and for privacy reasons in your computer. If for some reason you mess up those settings, you can also restore those defaults by clicking on this button here, Restore Defaults. Under the View area, and this is where we are getting more granular, this is where you can specify additional options, whether you want to show certain items or not, and you can apply this to all the folders. Now, if you make changes in your PC and you want to go back to revert back to the default options, you can always click here on Reset Folders, and that will reset all the settings to the default folder settings. As I mentioned earlier, you also have the tabbed browsing here in File Explorer. The advantage of this is that you can navigate to various folders in your PC, and instead of interfacing between various windows, you're just interfacing via the various tabs in your computer here.